Ms. Pat is a comedian with her own incredible story to tell. So first, with two kids, by the time she was 15, she even sold drugs to provide for her family, and it was her caseworker who told her that she had a talent for telling funny stories, so she's found a way to a stage.
And today she shares this story and more in her new life as a comedian and author. Ms. Pat, thank you so much for being here with us.
Thank you for having me. Thank you, thank you. I'm up early with no kids. And
it's
Jesus is cold.
Okay.
Are you chilly too?
No. I'm 46. I had to put my panty line in the microwave.
Miss Pat, you had us cracking up already all morning.
Yes, yes. I'm always waking up talking stuff. I saw y'all talking about cursing. My first word is I wake up cursing. Okay. I like to curse. I like to curse.
How does it make you feel when you cuss?
Oh, it made me feel empowered.
I hear you.
Yeah.
Let's dive in here. So to say that you came from a tough background, that's an understatement. We briefly touched on it just a second ago in the intro, but it's so much more than that. Can you just give us a little bit of your story?
Well, I had two kids by a married man by the time I was 15. Lost a nipple in a drive-by. And I tell women all the time, you don't need two nipples.
You've
that overrated.
Shot.
Yeah, I've been shot a couple
okay.
times. I'm not from Chicago either. And, you know, I sold drugs, went to prison, turned my life around, got my GED, and raised my kids not to do what I did.
So how did the name of your book, The Rabbit, come about?
Well, Rabbit was my drug dealer name, because I don't know if you guys ever sold drugs, but you can't use your legal name. They prefer if you pick
That's
a name off the street.
Pick
you would be good as a drug dealer named Riri.
But, okay.
What could be my drug name?
I don't, bald head.
Bald head?
Bald
I like
head.
It though.
I like just bald.
Bald.
Bald. Have you seen bald? Have you talked to bald?
Okay. No, my husband is bald. So I turned my life around and I went to the welfare office to get over, you know, to tell some sad stories. And they switched my caseworker from a white lady to a black lady and she wasn't falling for the lie.
Mm-hmm.
And so she was like, I think you're very funny. You should go and get, be a comedian. I was like, I don't want a job. I just want to watch The Young and the Restless. And she was like, no, you should really do it. And I just tapped into it. And I'm a convicted felon. So this is the only job I've ever done that they didn't have to check my background. So I was like, y'all not gonna check my background? Bam, I can do this. So I just went on stage and just started telling all my business.
You know what I love about your story is that similar to Tiffany Haddish's story of where she had a social worker tell her that, you know, you could have a career in this. What message would you give to other people that are maybe struggling and saying that I wanna make a change?
Just believe in yourself. I mean, everybody got their hidden talent. Mm-hmm. And the only thing that pushed my hidden talent to the top is because I'm a convicted felon. Mm-hmm. Because think about it, if I would have went off and did what y'all did, college and all of that nice stuff, I'd probably be somewhere social worker hating my job. But I get to talk about people and I get paid and I can say whatever I want mm-hmm. to and I don't have to edit myself. So I'm glad my life took that turn.
Yeah, one thing I just have to give credit to you is amazing. I think it's your honesty, mm-hmm. your raw, real honesty in a take no stuff kind of way is why we just are drawn to you.
Yeah.
I'm like that at the house. I say what I gotta say. Like, I have a gay daughter. I have a gay daughter, and I support gay nibs, whatever make you happy. But my gay daughter is, she's a freak. Like, she just date all of these different girls.
Okay.
And she leave behind animals like, her daddy used to leave behind babies. I'm like, stop adopting animals with your gay girlfriends and you leave them.
She is not stopping.
I'm serious.
Her book is called Rabbit. It's available in stores now.
She's in town sharing her funny stories at Zanies in Old Town through Saturday. For ticket information, visit Zanies.com.
Zanies.com.
Zanies, excuse me.
Zanies. I got you.